Hello guys, good afternoon. Hope you are all doing well. I am your host Anvay Joshi and welcome to AutoIncline.com. It is the channel for people inclined towards cars and their rampant technologies. In today's video, we are going to review the Kia Seltos. It was the first car introduced by Kia in the Indian market and also the car to introduce the BS6 compliant petrol and diesel engines. So in this video, we are going to see how the car looks from the outside. We are going to check the comfort levels inside. We are going to see what's underneath the chassis. At the end, we are going to take it out for a thorough drive. At last, we'll discuss the car's pricing and my verdict. So without further waiting, let's take a look at the new Seltos. So let's start from the front and with these headlights. These are an array of LEDs with the daytime running lights and the turn indicators integrated in a single unit. In the center is the Kia's signature tiger nose grille, which gets knurled accents on the top and also on the bottom. Since this is the top end variant, you get the red badging and the front camera, and the parking sensors are also standard. Below the front grille is also the air dam, which is finished in brushed silver accents and a red lining on its skid plate. And finally, below the headlights are the fog lights. So from the front, the car certainly looks badass. Let's come to the side now. You can see that the car gets black claddings below the swage lines, which again go over these wheel arches. Speaking about the wheels, the car gets 17-inch diamond cut alloys with 215/60 rubber around them. Since this is a top end variant, you get the disc calipers painted in red color along with the wheel caps. Coming to the mirrors, these are the electronically folding and adjustable mirrors which house the LED turn indicators and the lane assist camera. Next to that is the chrome lining, which starts from the bottom of the A pillar and goes all the way back at the C pillar. The door handles are also finished in chrome, and the driver's side door handle also gets the smart key access system. And now moving to the back, the car gets the LED tail lights, which are connected really nicely with the chrome lining going via the Kia logo. Below the logo and above the number plate is the reverse parking camera, and on the rear bumper you get the silver brushed accents again with the red lines at its skid plate, and the parking sensors are standard in all the variants. Finally, you also get some light reflectors on the rear bumper next to this boot lid. Since we are at the back, let's just open up the boot. The boot space offered in the Kia Seltos is a ginormous 433 liters. If you feel that space is not enough, you can obviously see that the rear seats are foldable in the 60 to 40 configuration. Underneath this low tray, you will find the spare tire with a mechanical jack. So overall, I have to say the car from all the angles certainly looks beautiful and badass. And Kia has managed to give us a design which is absolutely unique and does not feel like it is being copied from any other car existing in the worldwide market. So now, let's reach back to the front and open up the engine bay. The Kia Seltos gets 3 engine and 4 transmission options. The one which you are looking right now is a 1.5 liter turbo diesel engine that makes 115 horsepower and 250 newton meters of torque. This engine delivers all that power to the front wheels via the 6-speed torque converter automatic or a 6-speed manual gearbox. The other petrol options are the 1.5 liter petrol engine that makes 115 horsepower but slightly less, 144 newton meters of torque. That engine can also be coupled to a CVT gearbox, and for performance oriented people, Kia has given a 1.4 liter turbocharged petrol engine that makes 140 horsepower with 242 newton meters of torque. And that engine, alongside the 6-speed manual, can also be equipped with a 7-speed dual clutch gearbox. You can see that the engine is transversely mounted on the front axle and it delivers the power to the front wheels. Hence, the drivetrain layout of the Seltos is called front engine, front wheel drive. Well, now we have seen how beautiful the car looks from the outside and what's underneath its chassis. Now, let's check the comfort levels of the rear seat first and then of the front seats. Now, let's talk about these rear seats. For my height of 5 feet 8 inches, you can observe I have more than sufficient amount of leg room, and the headroom is also really nice. what could have been slightly better is that the thigh support which I am getting is not up to the mark. If the thigh support could have been improved, that would have certainly amplified the comfort to a complete different level. Now I am seated on the front, and the front seats compared to the rear are really much more comfortable. The thigh support which I am getting is really nice, and the seats engulf me nicely and also provide me the correct driving posture. Taking a look at the dashboard, this dashboard with its contrasting white and black color certainly looks premium despite some hard plastics that are being used. But overall, the quality of the materials being used is really nice. I do have to point out that when I look at the steering wheel and this gear lever, that to some extent reminds me of the Audi cars. Now, before I push that engine start stop button and take the car out for a thorough drive, let's take a look at some of the feature highlights of the Seltos.
The feature highlights of the car are 6 airbags, tilt and telescopic steering wheel, 10.25 inch infotainment system, air purifier, ventilated seats, sunroof, electrically adjusting driver's seat, red ambient lighting, wireless charging, Bose premium 8-speaker sound system, and my favorite, the 8-inch heads-up display.
After taking a look at the car from the outside, seeing what's underneath its chassis, seeing the comfort levels and some of the feature highlights, now it's finally time to take the Seltos out for a thorough drive. So after driving the car for a short amount of time, I have to say acquaintance is certainly a strong point of the car. That is because not only I get an excellent visibility of the road, but I also get a commanding visibility of the engine bonnet. That certainly helps me in getting used to the car in intense traffic conditions in a very short amount of time. Along with that, the factors or the features which contribute to increase your acquaintance are the lane assist cameras and the driver seat height adjustment function. With all of these features and the visibility, the acquaintance is the best in the Seltos. Now let's talk about the engine. The diesel engine produces an astounding 250 Nm of torque. This torque is certainly helpful when you want to overtake a slow moving car in front of you. To see how the engine responds, let me just put my foot down. The time required for that engine control unit to calculate and deliver that power to you once you put your foot down is really less, and that is a commendable job done by Kia. Due to which, this engine certainly feels peppy, and despite being a diesel engine, it feels well balanced and well refined. Speaking about the efficiency, in city as I am driving, the car will give you about 10 to 12 kilometers per liter, and on highways, it will give you about 15 to 16 kilometers per liter. Now let's talk about the transmission. Since I am driving the torque converter automatic, discussing about it, this gearbox upshifts and downshifts really smoothly and hence amplifies your comfort and driving pleasure. If you wish to take control of the shifts, all you have to do is shift the stick to the right and you are in control of the upshifts and downshifts. But considering my experience after driving the car, I would say just leave it in automatic mode and let the gearbox do its own thing. So, to sum it up, the transmission, despite being a torque converter automatic, has to be said, is really smooth and doesn't feel jerky at all. Let's talk about the brakes. The car gets disc brakes on all four wheels, and if you choose to go for a slightly lower variant, you will get the drum brakes on the rear axle. The stopping power provided by these brakes is really good, and the brake pedal response is also quite instantaneous. Along with the brakes, the anti-lock braking system, electronic brake distribution, electronic stability control are some of the features which you will get in the GTX Plus variant. Now let's talk about how the vehicle steers. The car gets an electric assist rack and pinion power steering. Although it turns really smoothly when you drive other cars in its competition with the Seltos, the steering wheel to some extent feels a touch harder than its rivals. But keeping that aside, the car's turning radius of 5.3 meters certainly helps you to take a U-turn very easily, whether you are on a broad lane or you are in a narrow lane. Now, let's talk about the suspensions. The car gets the MacPherson strut with coil springs on the front and the coupled torsion beam axle suspension in the rear. Now, as we went through that pothole which I just experienced, I can say that the suspensions handle the bumps and undulations really nicely. The suspensions feel a touch stiff when you maneuver the car through the potholes at higher speeds, but when you are driving the car at reasonable speed and also on a smooth tarmac, the car literally just glides. These suspensions are truly phenomenal in giving you the excellent levels of comfort which you desire once you have a seat inside the car and take it out for a short journey or all a long journey. Hence, the comfort is really fantastic. Now, let's see if I feel the same on the rear seats. Now, I'm seated at the back and this rear suspension system is doing a really good job in handling the bumps and undulations at slow speeds. However, once you maneuver the car over the speed breaker or through the pothole at higher speeds, you will certainly feel the thud or the undulations because you are seated pretty close to the wheel arch. If the thigh support could have been made slightly better, the comfort would have been to a complete different level. But Kia has found the perfect balance between the softness and the stiffness in both of the suspension systems. Now, all that is left is to discuss the pricing and my verdict. So, that was the drive of the Seltos. Talking about the car's pricing, the basic variant starts at 9.89 lakhs ex-showroom and the top-end GTX Plus variant which we drove starts at 16.49 lakhs. The things which need improvement, number one is the rear seat comfort. The thigh support could have been slightly better. And number two, the steering wheel could have been a touch softer. Keeping that aside, let's focus on the things which I absolutely love. Number one, as I am standing outside, is the design. Number two is the driving pleasure. And number three is the list of features which are highly demanded by the market. That's it for the Kia Seltos then, guys. If you have enjoyed this video, kindly hit that like and subscribe button, as hitting those two buttons certainly feels a motivation for me to bring more content for you guys. This is your host Anvay Joshi saying Auf Wiedersehen, and till the next video, request you all to please stay safe and take care. See you.